The fascinating history of the iPhone began in 2007 with the launch of the first cell phone announced at the Macworld convention.
Calling it iPhone.
The device consisted of two models, a 4GB model priced at $499 and a second 8GB version priced at $599. For this reason, some critics, like Microsoft CEO Steve Ballmer, came to laugh at the iPhone because of its exorbitant price tag.
When you saw that.
$500?
But iPhone proved the world wrong after becoming one of the most popular phone brands in the United States in less than a decade. This is an evolution of the iPhone. iPhone 3G. On June 9th, 2008, Apple released its direct successor, the iPhone 3G. The new model allowed connecting to 3G-based networks, which worked much faster, offering more storage, had built-in GPS, and was surprisingly less expensive. With a retail price of $199 for the 8GB model and $299 for the 16GB version, iPhone sales skyrocketed, as it offered twice the speed at half the price. I think it wasn't such a good idea to sell little Timmy to get the first model. iPhone 3GS. The iPhone 3GS was twice as fast as its predecessor and ran iPhone 3.0, a version before iOS 8. One curious thing about this phone is that its shape did not vary from its previous version. However, its increased speed was enough to attract new followers to the company. iPhone 4. On June 7th, 2010, the iPhone 4 arrived along with the new iOS 4. This new model had a 4-megapixel camera, offered up to 64 gigabytes of storage, and marked the arrival of FaceTime video chat. A few weeks after Steve Jobs had to step down from the company due to health problems, the company announced the iPhone 4S, which featured an 8-megapixel camera and 1080p video resolution. iPhone 5, iPhone 5S, and 5C. In 2012, the iPhone 5 was released. The iPhone 5 was the company's first phone to feature a chip manufactured in-house, and it was the first iPhone with 4G LTE support. A year later, the iPhone 5C and 5S were released. While the iPhone 5C was basically a cheaper and more colorful version than the iPhone 5, the iPhone 5S implemented Touch ID, so users could unlock the screen of their phones using their fingerprints. iPhone 6 and 6 Plus. The iPhone 6 and 6 Plus sold like hotcakes, and they came back faster and bigger than ever, with a Retina HD and up to 128 gigabytes of storage. For those poor, I mean nobler at heart, iPhone also released 16GB and 64GB versions of both models. With a better camera and faster autofocus, these phones became the ideal choice for recording videos and stories for social media. iPhone SE. The iPhone SE, released on March 31, 2016, was a much cheaper phone than the iPhone 6, introducing many new customers to the brand. However, people quickly forgot about its existence when the iPhone 7 came to the market. iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. The iPhone 7 and 7 Plus made a giant leap in performance, photo quality, and durability, and were the first iPhone models to become water-resistant. But hey, let's be honest, who would go within 500 meters of a water surface with an iPhone in their hand? iPhone 8, 8 Plus. The iPhone 8 was very similar to the iPhone 7, and they only renamed the phone and resold it for an additional $50. However, the iPhone 8 Plus was another leap in phone size for an additional $100. iPhone X, XR, XS, and XS Max. The iPhone X was released in 2017 and eliminated the home button to enable a more prominent display on a smaller phone. If having Touch ID recognition wasn't enough for you, the iPhone X also included Face ID recognition. In 2018, the iPhone XR hit the market for just $749, followed by the iPhone XS, which was faster than the XR and had a starting price of $999. iPhone 11, 11 Pro, and 11 Pro Max. In 2019, the iPhone 11, 11 Pro, and 11 Pro Max were released with a new ultra-angle camera that allowed users to capture incredible landscape photos. However, it wasn't until the arrival of iPhone 12 that things started to get really interesting. iPhone 12 Mini, iPhone 12 Pro, and 12 Pro Max. In late 2020, Apple released four iPhones virtually simultaneously for the first time in its history. In addition, the 12 series featured a complete upgrade aesthetically, boasting flat sides, slim bodies, a larger display, and a richer, deeper color set. iPhone 13 Mini, iPhone 13 Pro, and Pro Max. The 13 series introduced no significant changes and followed the same winning recipe. Make bigger and faster phones, and sell them more expensively than the Krabby Patty's secret formula.
You forgot your secret formula.
It also introduced a longer battery life, so that you can spend more hours watching TikToks than having a social life. But other than that, the series didn't bring anything we haven't already seen before. Even Steve Wozniak, Apple's co-founder, has said he can't tell the difference between the iPhone 12 and the iPhone 13. So if you want to pay more to get the same features, this is the phone for you. iPhone 14. Although the iPhone 14 has not yet been released, we are sure it will be a beast, and that we will have to sell a kidney to buy it. But before you sign a pact with the devil to buy the next model, be sure to subscribe to the channel to see more amazing technological evolutions. Thanks for watching. See you soon!